Hey guys, so before we start off this episode of the Devlog, I have something very important to say about the Devlog, which I think a lot of you don't want to hear, but I should say it anyway. I really want to mention, and I have mentioned it in a lot of community posts already, this is a Devlog, not a tutorial. A devlog means that I will be showing you guys the progress from start to finish of this game. It doesn't mean that I show every bit of code. So just copy and pasting the code from these videos is not gonna work because I'm not showing everything. So keep that in mind. I keep getting comments. Why is the code not working? Help, my enemies aren't moving. This is not a tutorial. You can use the code and the functions that I use in the video to improve your own work, but never just copy and paste. You don't learn anything from it, and if you copy and paste from these videos, your project just isn't going to work. I just really had to mention that. Anyway, I hope you guys will enjoy this episode. Would you look at that? We're back at our project. And you know what? I did a lot of building of camera, which is really, really fun, really, really cool. And the first thing that I want to show you is we actually created a brand new map on stream. I had to finish it off stream afterwards, but let's head to the map and see what we created on stream. So over here we have the first map for the game. It's probably not gonna be the very first stage because it is very, very big. It has two entrances for the enemies. So one over here, and one over here, which is a lot faster to reach the top. And you have to stop the enemies from reaching the fireplace. And honestly, because our project looks so boring right now, let's implement the map right away. For now, I'm gonna place a spawn right over here. And yeah, so obviously, you probably were wondering, yes, we do need to set up all these little nodes on this map, and it has a lot of turns, it has a lot of slopes, so this is probably gonna take a little while. Let's put all the nodes in, shall we? Okay, so we set up all the nodes, and as we can see, it is actually working pretty, pretty nice. So they're moving all the way up here, all the way up the mountain, la 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 la. I do see something that I'm a little bit scared about, and that's that they're actually taking a long time turning. And because this map has so many turns, they are really slowly going up. So that is a bit of a problem. Anyway, as you guys can see, we have a bit of a problem. And that is, they're only coming from this side and not from this side. And this is because our system isn't set up yet to pick a random path at the start. So we need to code that real quick. And it's gonna be really simple. We're just gonna put it in an array and let the system pick out. So for us, that means that instead of path, we do paths. And we're gonna make it an array instead. There we go. And we're gonna do workspace node B. So now we have node A and node B. So over here, before we spawn the enemy, we're gonna set up a random path. So we're gonna do local path equals, and then we're gonna do paths, and then we're gonna do this map random one hashtag paths, and now this picks out the path, and we're gonna send the path in the spawn enemy. We're gonna set it in here. And that should get the path in the spawn enemy. And then in here we do a new value. So we're going to do path value equals instance.new object value, and the parent is entity. Make sure to give path value a name, because that's really, really important. So we're going to do path value. Okay, now we're just going to do path, because then we can do path.value. Okay, that's good. And then over here at local.node equals, and we're going to do entity.path.value. And now it should pick out the correct path. At least I hope it does. Let's test it out and see if we get an error. Oh, we do have an error. Wait, what? Why? Let's see. So there is an attempt at get children from the next node. But how? Second try is the charm. I don't see an error yet. So we got enemies going up here, and we got a very fast enemy going there. So let's use fly mode. So these are going up very, very nicely. Let's go. Nice. These are going up this way, and they're all coming together at the end here, which is really, really cool. Oh, that's a lot of slow enemies. Look at them go. Now, since this map is really, really big, I will obviously make sure that there are a lot of big enemies on this map, like very fast and tanky enemies, or else it's gonna be a bit too simple. Now, the next thing that I wanna do this episode is tower placement. So, not tower attacking, but tower placement. And for that, I already created a little button GUI. It does nothing at the moment. It's just a button GUI. We're not gonna worry about coins yet. We're just gonna worry about placement. And it's gonna be an entirely separate script on the client. So make sure that if you're gonna do something similar to this, you use a local script. So this is gonna be the tower that we're gonna be using. He is very, very cute. He has a mustache, and that means he is serious, serious business. As for the script, I already created a little bit. So we find a local player, we find a GUI, and we do something when we click on the button, obviously. So the first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna spawn a decoy into the world. So a function spawn decoy, I'm going to do local decoy equals workspace.tower.clone, and we're going to place the decoy into the workspace. So decoy.parent equals workspace. Okay, that's all very, very useful. And we're going to make decoy dot transparency, we're gonna make it 0.5, so when he spawns, he is semi transparent. Now of course we also need to know where our mouse is pointing at the moment, because if it's not pointing anywhere, where are we gonna place the tower, right? So to find the placement of the decoy position, what we're gonna have to do is we're gonna do mouse.hit. So that is what the mouse is, like the position where the mouse is currently hitting something, .p, and the p stands for position. But our tower is big, like if we just use this code, the decoy would spawn half in the ground. So what we're gonna do is plus vector3.new 0 to 0, because our block is 4 high, so the origin of the block is in the middle. So if we add 2 to that number, our block will not be in the middle of the map. And to test it out, we can do spawn decoy in this code, and then we basically spawn a decoy. So let's test it out, I guess. So since my mouse would be over this button, the block should spawn over here. So click, and it errored. Okay, let's test that out. Click, and there is a block. But it isn't following our mouse, and we can place like a lot of them. So yeah, it needs to follow our mouse, obviously. So what we're gonna do now is that when we click the button is gonna disappear until we replace our tower down. So let's code that. Okay, so in this movement code, all we're gonna do is just copy this, and this should work. This is current decoy, by the way, because we store it up here in a current decoy, and we also want to make sure that if current decoy equals nil, and we do this an or, so if we are not spawning, or if our current decoy equals nil, then we're not gonna do this line of code. So this should make it so it's following our mouse, which is exactly what we wanted. So now we also need to code that if we click the mouse, we place the decoy, basically. Okay, so let's test that out. Spawn tower and So now, for everyone in the comments, what do you think is happening? So what is happening is, it is indeed following our mouse. Only problem is, it is also detecting this block as a valid placement option, which is not what we want. Ha ha ha, this sucks. How are we gonna fix that? Well, we're gonna fix that using a simple whitelist system. We are just gonna do mouse.targetFilter equals current decoy. So this way the mouse isn't affected by its own tower. Honestly, using mouse.hit is not the best way to do this. I would honestly use a raycast, but to get the basics down, I'm gonna use mouse for now. So now, as you can see, we can put the tower literally everywhere. So I'm like, you know, let's put it on, I don't know, let's put it here, because this is very cool, very fun. Click, and we got the tower. We can spawn in a great, we can spawn in a new one. Huh, why is that? That is very strange. It is probably because we messed something up. See, and this is why you always check the code. Boom. Is spawning equals false? We didn't place it there. And now, as you can see, we can place endless towers everywhere. Yay, even on the tree, even on the walls. Yay. Oh my god, this is so cool. Woohoo. Woohoo. Okay, so yeah, that is something that we desperately, desperately need to fix. And there are a couple of ways that you can do that. What I like to do is we're gonna place a part over the map called placeable. And you can place your towers only on placeable parts. So yeah, let's actually try that out right now. So these are the parts called placeable, and I'm literally gonna put it everywhere where you can place a tower. So, for example, I don't want the player to place a tower on these shelves, so we're not gonna allow that. There we go. La 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 la. Of course, watch out for the trees. Okay, so my recording suddenly paused, but I did fill in most of the sand. Unfortunately, I didn't have time to do the entire mountain because I got a very important job interview in like a couple of minutes. But anyway, if you click spawn tower, now you can see that over here it is red and over here it is green. Meaning that if it's red, you can hear my mouse, you cannot place it down. But when it's on the green, bam! There we have him, nice and placed. And of course you can place as many as you want. But honestly, that is basically the basics of tower placement. There are parts where you can't place them, and there are parts where you can place them. And that is what a tower defense game is all about. Now, I need to go to the job interview. But before we go there, I do have something to show you. Because I did actually already create some enemies and a tower to use in the next episode. Let's take a look. So this is the world in which I create all the assets for the game and the maps. And over here we have the first enemies for the game, all fully animated and worked out. Now don't worry, in the next episode I am gonna show you guys how to do this. That's why we have this little crap over here not animated yet, so don't worry about that. But yeah, these are the enemies that's gonna be in the game. And over here we have the tower that's gonna be in the game. It's a s'more and his name is Toast, and he's a fire type unit. Now don't worry about it, I will explain units and elements and all the other things I have planned for the game pretty soon, but for now just know this is gonna be one of the towers. In the next episode, we're gonna make the tower placement grid-based, because that is something that I really want for this project. And we're also finally gonna make the game look even nicer, because we're finally gonna apply models to the enemies. I've been seeing that you guys had a lot of problems figuring that one out, so yes, we are going to fix that in the next episode, so feel free to take inspiration from that. But anyway, I got a very important job interview to get to, so I'm gonna cut it short here. Thank you guys all so much for watching. If you like these dev vlogs, please leave a like and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next dev vlog, and we're gonna make this game very, very awesome. See ya!